George, is that you? Well, I'm so glad you've come. Why don't you smile and ask after Harry?
I wish he'd never been born. I wish I'd never been born myself.
George!
I wish I was dead.
Oh, now, George, that's really wicked. Now, I know how you feel about losing your place at the factory and all, and you have a hard master.
My master.
And who made him my master? That's what I think of. What right is he to me? I'm as much a man as he is. What right is he to make a jailhouse of me? And you don't even know the hope yet.
What do you mean?
Oh, lately my master's been saying that he was a fool to let me marry off the place. That he hates Mr. Shelby and all his tribe. And that I should take a wife and settle down on his place.
But you was married to me by the minister, as if you'd been a white man.
Don't you know I can't hold you for my wife if he chooses to part us? That is why I wish I'd never seen you. It would have been better for both of us. It would have been better for our poor child had he never been born.
My master's always been so kind.
Yes. But who knows? He may die and Harry may be sold to nobody knows who. But what pleasure is it that he is handsome and smart and bright? I tell you, Eliza, that a sword will pierce your soul for every good and pleasant thing your child is or has. It's going to make him worth too much for you to keep.
Oh,
heaven forbid. So, Eliza. My girl. You bear up now. Goodbye. Well, I'm going.
Going? George? Going where?
To Canada. And when I'm there, I'll buy you. That's all the hope has left us. You have a kind master that won't refuse to sell you. I'll buy you and the boy. Heaven helping me, Eliza, I will.
George. Whatever you should be taking.
I won't be taken, Eliza. I'll die first. I'll be free or I'll die.